Hi, my name is Alyssa, and I draw all kinds of stuff on this channel. This video is a very special video. Not only will I be going over using some watercolor brushes for Procreate and how you can incorporate these kinds of brushes into your workflow, but I'm also drawing inspiration from these specific classic Winnie the Pooh illustrations, and I'm doing so for a very specific, very special person. So let's get right into the video. So if you guys are new to my channel, first of all, welcome. I'm so happy to have you here, and you should probably hit subscribe because I do art videos like this every single week. But also, if you're new to my channel or you may have missed the last couple videos I posted, I've mentioned a couple times, but I should put it out front and center since it's like the whole point of this video. My sister is pregnant. She is due any day now. Like, by the time this video goes up, in theory, the baby could be here. You know, it's right around the corner. I'm going to be an aunt for the first time. I can't wait to spoil this kid. I'm really looking forward to being like the world's coolest aunt. I'm really excited for my sister, and it's all just very exciting. So I wanted to make some art for the nursery to match the theme, which is obviously Winnie the Pooh, and I wanted to draw inspiration from these classic Winnie the Pooh illustrations, which I'll talk about more in just a second. But I also wanted to mention that this video is on a playlist called For My Niece. I've also started a playlist, well, the other video that's on the playlist, rather, is a video I did of a painting of a baby. And I started the playlist with the intention that every time I make a video that's inspired even slightly by my niece, I want to put it on this playlist, and eventually, one day when it's reached a decent amount of money, the amount of ad revenue that all these videos have gathered, I want to give to her as like a birthday or a Christmas gift, whenever it's accumulated like a decent amount of money and not like $10, you know, like a decent gift for her. I just like the idea of like having these videos not only to make a couple bucks for her birthday, but also to have like this cool memory log of like this trip through time, like before she was born and like the first cartoon she's really interested in. I obviously want to do art of that, and like I can practice getting better at drawing people by like drawing artwork of her, or I don't know, just I can think of a bunch of things that are inspired by her to do videos of while she's still a baby, and then when she gets older and has her own interests, I can do videos about like the funny things she said, and also drawing like her favorite cartoon characters or whatever it may be, and it'll be cool to take this trip down memory lane with her later in her life. I think it would just be really fun to have like an archive of how I was thinking and feeling in regards to my niece, and maybe one day she'll do a video with me and we can both sit and draw together and put it on the playlist. Like, that would be so much fun. Like, it's just something to look forward to, and I think it's a really fun idea. So yeah, that's why this is on a playlist called For My Niece. That's the whole function of it, if you guys were curious about why that playlist is on my channel. So, back to talking about the actual artwork, I wanted to do a piece that was Winnie the Pooh, but specifically classic Winnie the Pooh, because I think that's the style my sister prefers, is the more vintage, kind of warm, cozy illustration styles of the books versus the Disney animated movie style. So the original Winnie the Pooh illustrations were done by illustrator E.H. Shepherd, and I found mixed results on Google. The tough thing about Winnie the Pooh, especially classic Winnie the Pooh, is it's hard to find an image source that's like high resolution or a scan directly from a book I found. A lot of them are kind of low resolution, and it's hard to tell if they're E.H. Shepherd illustrations or if they're illustrations done by a different illustrator for a different book, because all the sources end up going to somebody's Pinterest wall or something like that. So I just pulled the images in particular that I was most drawn to, whether it was like the coloring style or the style of how they drew Tigger or whatever. I just pulled my favorite batch of illustrations and got inspired by them all separately. So for this classic Winnie the Pooh style, I had to consider two different things about imitating it, the inking and the watercolor. The inking you've been watching me do, I did with the Technical Pen, which is a default Procreate brush. It's just under inking. It's one of the pens that comes with Procreate. And I did that not only because I didn't want to spend any more money on brushes, because I had just spent $20 on a watercolor brush pack that was well worth it. I'll talk about it in a moment. But also because I thought it would be a good, clean, thin line brush that would get kind of the look I wanted. I did end up dirtying up some of the edges of the brush with a little bit of 6B pencil brush texture later in the process, just to make it look a little bit more, I don't know, like a ballpoint pen or some kind of inking thing that you would do in real life. I wanted it to look a little bit messy on some of the edges. I don't know if it added anything or not, but it made me feel better about it. It made me feel like it was less digital, but I got over that quickly when I started adding the watercolors. It felt a lot less digital once I had just even the paper texture in and started layering in the colors. But overall, I think the inking looks a lot like the example images. It's kind of loose. I wasn't worried about getting smooth lines for once. I was just kind of even adding in a little bit of wiggle and shake to my lines to get that nice uneven look that makes the original Pooh illustrations so charming. I wasn't paying so much attention to getting crisp, smooth lines, because that's not really the point of these kinds of things. When you want to add charm and simplicity and almost like a folk art quality to it, you want to stop focusing on making things perfect and neat and tidy, because it kind of takes away from the feeling. So here I am just playing around with the different watercolor brushes in this pack. I'll put a link to it in the description below. It is $20, but I think it's highly, highly worth it, because I had honestly tried a couple free things and they weren't the same. These actually feel like drawing with or painting with watercolor brushes, and there's all kinds of brushes in the pack I didn't even get around to using. I mainly stuck to just the basic simple brushes. There's like basic simple and basic starter or something like that. They're both called basic something or starter, beginner, or something along those lines. And those two I used for almost everything, honestly. And I changed the smudge tool to different things. There's some that smudge almost like you're adding more water to your paper, and there's some that smudge like just blending colors into each other, which I used a little bit on areas where, so when you paint with watercolor, it's almost like drawing with like a highlighter or something, where if you put a layer and then you put another layer, it gets darker. So it works the same way digitally, and in areas that got a little bit too dark, I would take that smudge and kind of blend them in together to smooth it out a little bit without getting rid of that nice like paint texture. I was really impressed by how much these look and also feel and perform like watercolor. It was kind of crazy, especially on the balloon. I had to add like 4 layers of paint, and I added a shadow here and then just blended it out because I wanted it to still have that nice texture in the balloon and not be too solid, but I kind of wanted the balloon to be the focal point of the piece. Because the whole piece is supposed to tell a story. It's kind of obvious, you know, but the whole piece is really just saying, like, hi, welcome to the world, we're so happy to have you here, welcome to the party, kid. And everybody's being nice, even Pooh's being nice, which is funny. I was just looking at, if you guys haven't seen some of the Disney Winnie the Pooh comics, where he's just unnecessarily rude for no reason. He's kind of a jerk, you know, Winnie the Pooh, but he's being nice and even offering food to the baby, which is something that Winnie the Pooh, he's got to really like you to offer up food that he's not going to eat himself. That's a very kind gesture of Pooh. But even Eeyore is smiling, like everybody's happy to see the new arrival to the party. So I wanted this to be a very happy, like, welcome to the world kind of piece, and I intend to get it matted and sent out. I don't want to frame it because I feel like the glass will shatter in the mail, but I want to print it at this nice local place that does like watercolor texture printing that'll just add to the natural look and feel of the piece. Even though it was done digitally, it'll feel like it was done with real watercolor when it's printed out, you know, knock on wood, fingers crossed. But I want it to look and feel very rich and warm like this, and have a nice like cream colored matting, and then my sister can pick out whatever frame she wants and I'll pay her for it, and she can have it framed and put up in the nursery wherever she wants, and I'll make it a reasonable size print, like 8x10. It's not going to be super huge or super dinky. It'll be like a nice size, and I'm hoping it'll fit somewhere along the wall where the crib is or something like that, or even above where the rocking chair is for story time or something. I have visions of all the art I'd love to do for the nursery as she, or her room, as she grows older and it becomes, you know, it transforms from a nursery into a proper kids' room, and she has her own interests and her own favorite colors and her own favorite animals, and it's very exciting to think about, and I can't wait to be a part of all of that, you know, and put my own stamp on her childhood and, you know, her good memories growing up, you know, like, oh, I love that painting my Aunt Alyssa made it for me, or whatever weird nickname she'll come up, you know, with for me. I gotta wonder if she'll call me Aunt Alyssa, or if, like, Alyssa will be too many syllables and she'll just call me, like, Lyssa or something like that, or if she'll come up with some other weird nickname. I guess in time we'll see, but I'm gonna let her pick what to call me, you know. I'm not gonna pick my own aunt name. You know how some moms like pick their grandma name? They're like, I want to be called Mimi or whatever, and they tell the grandkid, like, you're gonna call me Mimi. Like, I think grandmas have that authority to like tell the kid, like, no, you're gonna call me Mimi. but I don't think aunts have that power. Like, I don't get to tell my niece what she calls me. She's gonna call me what she's gonna call me, and I'm just gonna have to deal with it, you know? So, I guess in time we'll see pretty soon here, you know? Before I know it, I'm gonna blink my eyes and she'll be walking and talking and whatever, you know? Time's going so super, super fast. But also, you know, like, this year it's been crawling by, so I'm happy that at least, like, this whole baby thing, this whole, like, being an aunt thing has been, like, a big thing to look forward to this whole year, despite everything that's going on in the world, you know? So we're all gonna, like, laugh when she's older, like, you know, you were the only good thing to happen in 2020, you know that? Like, that'll be the recurring stupid relative joke that she has to hear for her entire life, like, yeah, I know, and she won't even remember 2020, you know? But that'll be the stupid thing that every relative tells her and her family for the next God knows how many years, and she's gonna be sick of it. But it's gonna be funny, and I'm gonna enjoy telling her that she was the only good thing to happen in 2020 for a lot of us. But you know, that's not true entirely. Like, I've been making more YouTube videos, and people have been responding positively to that, so I've seen growth in that regard. I've seen more growth in my my freelance has been taking off a little bit more when it was, like, really sluggish at the beginning of the year when things were really rough, like March, April, May, June, and now it's starting to pick back up again, and, you know, other things are going well for me and others, but, you know, this has been, like, the big main event to look forward to because I haven't been able to plan, like, trips or shows or the normal big things that I'd be looking forward to. It's more like looking forward to art projects and videos and stuff like that, but this is, like, something big to look forward to, is, like, I'm gonna be an aunt. Like, this is a big deal. So yeah, talking about the art again instead of gushing about how exciting and interesting and weird and cool it is gonna be to be an aunt for the first time, but yeah, so using these watercolors was a very interesting experience, and I'd love to get a better grasp of how to use them because I would like to try to do other illustrations with these brushes, maybe not in this classic Poo style, but I really liked kind of surrendering perfectionism when it comes to line crispness when drawing these things. It was just like a very simple, like, shaky hand almost kind of feel I was putting into it. It was a very relaxing art style to kind of imitate and take inspiration from in that regard. It was very freeing to, like, not care if the colors are perfect in the lines, because it made it look better and more realistic if they kind of bled out and were imperfect. It gave it a warm, friendly quality. So if you're somebody who struggles with, like, doing really neat, clean lines or really neat digital coloring, I would highly recommend this brush set and, like, just give it a try and see what kinds of cool color effects you can get. You can do all kinds of crazy stuff with these brushes. I had done on another canvas just smudging colors into each other, and it looked really, like, satisfying. You can, like, blend some hot pink into some blue and, like, take the water smudger brush and get really nice painterly effects that look really good and really realistic. So, like, totally give these a try, and do tag me in any stuff you make with these brushes. I don't have an affiliate link with this brush pack. I'd done other videos where I was using and recommending the Jing Sketch brushes, which I don't use in this video, and that has an affiliate link, but these I just straight up bought with my own money. I saw a YouTube video about them, and I thought they looked really good, and I watched other demos of people using them and thought, okay, these are the ones I want to use. So I bought them with my own money. I don't make any money if you download them with the link in the description. It's just straight up recommendation. I think they're really great, and they feel so real. It's crazy. So I wanted to get that nice checkerboard, gingham, whatever, picnic blanket texture, and it was very, very easy to do with this because, like I said, the nature of watercolor is that when you layer it, obviously when you do a second layer, the intersection of the first and the second layer is going to get just a tad bit darker, which is exactly what you want to happen with a pattern like gingham like this, where the lines cross, it gets ever so slightly darker. So it made a really nice, like, fabric effect with very little effort. It was, like, almost effortless to make this tablecloth, and I think it turned out looking really cute. So again, this was a very, like, this illustration came together pretty simply and pretty quickly, all things considered, even though it took a couple hours. It was really my first time using these brushes for a full illustration and doing this kind of line art style, but altogether I think the piece came out pretty effectively. I think it's gonna look really cute in the nursery. I can't wait to see it on the wall and how it blends in with, like, the color scheme of the room and the other decor in the room and stuff like that. I think it's a really nice piece, and I'm really looking forward to taking these watercolor brushes for another spin and trying them out on some other pieces of artwork as well. Here I'm just doing some very super last minute adjustments and adding my signature, of course. I didn't want to put Alyssa Aaron, why would I? It's for my niece, so I just put Alyssa with a heart. And whatever she ends up calling me later when she gets older, Alyssa or Auntie Alyssa or whatever she wants to call me, I'll sign all the future artwork for her with whatever her name for me is later down the line. So here's the final piece. All in all, I think it came out really good for my first time using watercolor brushes. I hope my niece likes it when she's old enough to appreciate art. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you guys have a fantastic rest of your day.